Hello everyone. In this lecture, we are going to see unit number 3. Name of the unit is DC to DC converters and AC voltage controller. We are going to see choppers in this unit. Subtopics of this unit are, we are going to start with the introduction about chopper. We will see principle of operation, method of control, step up and step down chopper with inductive load. Myself, Professor Amit Kumar Mishra. I am having total 10 years of teaching experience and my domain expertise is of 10 years. Let's start with the introduction. First of all, what is chopper? So chopper is a static device. A variable DC voltage is obtained from a constant DC voltage source. It is also known as DC to DC converter. Widely used for motor control. Also used in regenerative braking. Choppers offer greater efficiency, faster response, lower maintenance, smaller size, and smooth control. Types of chopper. So there are two types of chopper. One is step-down chopper, another one is step-up chopper. Step-down chopper, as name indicates, here the output voltage is less than input voltage. For step-up chopper, in step-up chopper, output voltage is more than the input voltage. Principle of step-down chopper means how step-down chopper works. So you can see over here, we are giving the fixed DC from the input. We have a chopper, we have a switch and a load, resistive load. So when the switch will be closed, at that time, this input fixed DC is getting connected with the load. So we are going to get the output across the load, resistive load. When the switch is off, at that time, this voltage source, input source, will get cut off from the load. So we won't get any output during off period. Again, when the switch will be on, the source will be getting connected to the load and we are going to get the output voltage across the load. So during T on, we will get the output. During T off, we won't get the output. So because of this switch, this fixed DC is getting converted into variable DC. This switch, we can use either a power MOSFET or any IGBT. This is the output voltage and current waveform. So we are getting the output in case of step down chopper during T on period, and we won't get the output during T off period. This is output voltage, output current, the shape is same because of resistive load, whereas its magnitude is less as compared to voltage. Why? Because current is voltage upon resistance. So as the voltage is getting divided by resistance, so magnitude of current will be less. Performance parameter. We will see the performance parameters of step down chopper, but before going on that, we will see few notifications. What is VDC? So it is average value of output voltage. What is IDC? It is average value of output current. T on, time interval for which switch conducts. T off, time interval for which switch is off. Total T, that is T on plus T off. Period of switching or chopping period. F, that is 1 by T. It is frequency of chopper switching or chopping frequency. Now let's see the first parameter, that is average output voltage. So VDC is equal to V into T on upon T on plus T off. So what is this T on plus T off? It is total time. What is VDC? VDC is V into T on by T. So this V, T on by T is D. This D is duty cycle. What is next parameter? It is average output current. IDC is equal to VDC upon R. What is VDC? VDC is V T on upon T. So IDC is equal to V by R into D. Third is RMS value of output voltage. V naught is equal to under root of 1 by T. Integration 0 to T on V naught square dt. But during T on, V naught is equal to V. Therefore, RMS output voltage V naught is equal to under root of 1 by T integration 0 to T on V square dt. So this will give us V naught is equal to under root of V naught V square upon T into T on. So V naught is under root of D into V. Output power is V naught I naught. We know I naught is V naught upon R. So if we substitute the value of I naught in this, so we will be getting output power P naught is equal to V naught square by R. What is this V naught? So V naught is, in case of step down chopper, it is under root of D into V. What is D? D is duty cycle. So P naught is D V square upon R. Effective input resistance of chopper, Ri is equal to V by IDC, or Ri is equal to R upon D. The output voltage can be varied by varying the duty cycle. So this duty cycle, by varying this, we can change the output voltage. Next is the important one, that is methods of control. Now, what is the meaning of methods of control? Means a chopper converts fixed DC into variable DC. So at output, we are getting variable DC. Therefore, how we can control this output? So there are three methods for that. The first one is pulse width modulation control or constant frequency operation. This is also called as TRC, time ratio control. Second is variable frequency control. And third one is current limit control, CLC. Let's see each one of these methods one by one. So the first one is pulse width modulation, PWM, that is TRC, time ratio control. So T on is varied, keeping chopping frequency F and chopping period T constant. Output voltage is varied by varying that on period T on. So this output voltage you can see over here, this complete cycle is T, total time duration. This is T on, this is T off. So we have to keep this T constant, but we have to vary the T on in such a way that this T is going to remain constant. So if you see here, we have varied the T on, but total time, this is constant. So this is time ratio control, means from T on by T, we are changing T on. Or width of the pulse is also changing. So we can say it is pulse width modulation control. Second is variable frequency control. Alpha or small d, that is duty cycle, is T on upon T. What is 1 by T? It is frequency. So we can say that duty cycle is F into T on. So variable frequency control means we are going to vary the F, frequency. Frequency means we are going to vary the T. So this T we have to vary. So you can see over here, we have kept T on constant. See, T on in both the figure are constant. But we are able to vary the T. How? By varying the T off. So if you have varied the T off, initially it was here, now it has changed to this point. So our T got varied. So this is, if you have varied the T, means we have varied the frequency. Why? Because F is equal to 1 by T. So this is variable frequency control. Third is current limit control. What is current limit control method of control? In this, we have kept the limit of current between two values. One is minimum and x1 is maximum. If the current goes above maximum, the device will get off. And if it falls below maximum minimum, again the device will get off. So we have to keep the value of current between these two values, maximum and minimum. So this is current limit control. Let's see the next one, subtopic, that is step up chopper with inductive load. What is this step up chopper with inductive load? You can see over here, this is the figure of step up chopper. Here we have fixed input DC, this is inductor, here we have used chopper. In place of this, we can use power MOSFET or IGBT. Here we have a diode and this is the load where we are going to get the output voltage. Now the thing is, if I close this switch, what will happen? So this source, this inductor is going to get connected with the source. So the current will flow through this loop and it will pass through the inductor and inductor will store the energy. Happen when this chopper is on. Now when this chopper is off, at that time what will happen? So this inductor will lose the energy or dissipate the energy and we will get the output across the load V0. So during on period, we won't get the output, only inductor will store the energy in case of step up chopper. And during off period, inductor will store the energy and we are going to get the output. The same thing is written over here. So in terms of equation, the voltage across the load is V0 is equal to V plus L di over dt. Expression for output voltage. When chopper is on, energy stored in the inductor is Vi into T on. Where T on is on period of the chopper. When chopper is off, so energy supplied by the inductor is V0 minus V into I T off, where T off is off period of chopper. So For ideal condition or lossless condition, we will have VIT naught is equal to V naught minus V into IT off, from where we are getting. So this is the one during on period and this is during the off period. So we have to equate these two. So we are going to get this one. So V naught is equal to V into T on plus T off upon T off. So V naught is equal to V, T on plus T off is T. What is T off? T off is T minus T on, where T is chopping period or period of switching. V naught is V into 1 upon 1 minus T on upon T. What is T on upon T? It's duty cycle. So where D is T on upon T. So this is the expression of output voltage for step up chopper. Step up chopper. For variation of duty cycle D in the range of 0 to 1, the output voltage will vary from V to infinity for this equation. Next is step down chopper with inductive load. Since we have a fixed voltage, we have a chopper and we have this inductive load. Now how it will work? So when this chopper will be closed, at that time this load is getting connected with the source. So we will get the output across the load. When this chopper will be off, at that time the energy which was stored by the inductive load, it will dissipate that energy, and that energy will dissipate it through this freewheeling diode. So it will circulate over here. So during chopper is on, T on period, we will get the output. When chopper is off, we won't get the output because energy will be dissipated by the inductive load. So this is the output voltage. This is the output when T on, during T off, we won't get the output. This is the waveform for output current. Continuous mode, we will be getting in this fashion. During discontinuous mode, there will be fraction of second when we won't get the output current. So this is discontinuous current. RMS value of output current. So I naught RMS is I minimum square plus I max minus I min square upon 3 plus I min into I max minus I min under root of that. Next is RMS chopper current. So ICH is equal to under root of 1 by T 0 to dt integration of that I naught square dt. So ICH, current through the chopper. Current through the chopper means what? Current which is flowing through this chopper CH, or where CH PPER is written over here. Therefore, it is under root of 1 by T 0 to dt I min plus I max minus I min upon dt into T under square of that into dt. So ICH is equal to under root of D I min square plus I max minus I min square upon 3 plus I min into I max minus I min under root of that. So ICH is equal to under root of D I naught RMS. Effective input resistance is RI is equal to V upon IS, where IS is average source current, IS is DIDC, where D is duty cycle, or we can say RI is equal to V upon DIDC. In this lesson, we have learned introduction about chopper, principle of operation, control strategies, and step up chopper and step down chopper with inductive load. Thank you.